On and welcome to day two of ProQuest Books Week 2021. I hope wherever you are, you're all safe and well. If you're in the UK, we're experiencing a mini heat wave, so I hope you are staying cool or out in the sun, depending on what your preference is for the hot weather. I know which one mine is. So today's session is going to focus on Academic Complete. So the title is Academic Complete, A Perspective on Ebook Collection Strategy. And it's going to focus on our flagship ebook subscription product. My name is Tash Edmonds and I'm the UKI book sales manager. And today I'm going to be joined by a variety of guest speakers. But before we delve into the presentation, and we have a lot of information to share with you, I did just want to get through some housekeeping. So if anyone on the call is experiencing any technical difficulties, please contact Nick Tipping in the chat and she will be able to try and help you. Also, if you have any questions, we have a designated Q&A session at the end of the presentations. So please do, throughout the presentation, pop your comments or your questions into the chat feature. Also, take advantage of the Q&A section as well. So we're all recorded and we're ready to go. So from our ProQuest team today, we have three speakers. And I'm just going to move my slides along. They seem to have gone to sleep, so if you just bear with me. It must be the hot weather. I must be feeling fatigue. No, that doesn't seem to be working. What I'm going to do, everyone, apologies for the slight delay. I'm going to stop sharing and then reshare, and hopefully that will wake the presentation up. So if you just bear with us. Hoping that now everyone can see that's moved along. Perfect. I think it must have been suffering from sunstroke, but thank you for remaining patient. So as I was saying, we have five guest speakers today. Two of them are from the librarian world, and these sessions wouldn't be as successful as they are without having input from our librarian partners. And we have Anne Worden, who's the Faculty Librarian for Humanities and Social Sciences, and also the team leader for collection management at the University of Portsmouth. And also we have Hannah Britcher, who's the team leader for procurement and metadata, also from University of Portsmouth. And later on in the session, they're going to be sharing their experiences of using Academic Complete, and also how it's also proved a cost-saving measure as well in terms of the collection development for ebooks. And on the ProQuest side, we're joined by three colleagues, all with a wealth of experience. We have Wei Yi, who is the product manager for books. We have Vasuda, who is our senior product market analyst. And there's nothing that she can't do with a spreadsheet and with data. She is our complete data guru. And also we have RJ, who's our product marketing manager for books. So without further ado, I'm going to hand over to Wei Yi, I believe.
Tash, thank you. Hello, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, depending on what time zone you're currently at. Welcome to the ProQuest ebook webinar, and thank you for taking the time to join us in this sharing and discussing session on how data collected from ebook subscription could inform better, smarter, and more evidence-based decision for your schools, institutions, and libraries. And my name is Wei Yi. I am the product manager for ebook subscription here at ProQuest. Super excited to kick us off for an hour of conversations, joining by our ebook data expert, member from marketing team, and fellow librarians. So, no matter you have heard about ProQuest flagship ebook subscription solution, or try the trial version, or still deciding, learning about whether ebook subscription is the solution to schools or institutions, you're at the right place. Academic Complete, borrowing our librarian customers' words, is the foundational interdisciplinary ebook one-stop shop solution designed for academic libraries, curated by librarians and subject matter expertise, and evolved with the latest higher education landscape trend and thousands of libraries' real-time usage data. And as the product manager of Academic Complete, I am so proud of this trusted, award-winning ebook solution has been so far adopted by thousands of libraries from more than 100 countries across the world. It is a huge collection with year-to-date nearly 200,000 titles and continuously growing. But our goal from the ProQuest product team is to never compromise quality with quantity. And I will be spending the next couple of slides to explain what do I mean by that and what makes Academic Complete unique. Tash, could you please switch to the next slide? Thank you. And it's been 18 years since Academic Complete launches. And looking back, we have made purposeful development effort to strengthen this flagship solution from the inputs from thousands of librarians. And two major milestones I call out on this slide we had the past 3 years is the effort to first, expand non-English coverage, and second, a usage-based content development strategy. I will be expanding it a little bit in the next two slides. And we also try our best to take every effort to minimize the impact of title removals, which is common for subscription titles. And our biannually removal program ensures proactive updates to libraries and prevent any additional concerns around off-cycle changes. And it's worth noting, along with our promised year-over-year 6% of collection growth, we continuously monitor the latest trend in enrollment and graduation, emerging discipline, as well as the growing demand from classrooms and labs. Next slide, please, Tash. So going back to the quality over quantity piece, Academic Complete is providing the exclusive and relative content to support research, teaching, and learning that articulates the value of accessibility, diversity, and inclusion. The past year of 2020 is indeed challenging with a sudden shift of distance learning, teaching, and researching. And everything could not be happening overnight, but having over the 26,000 DRM titles and unlimited usage model option for our subscription titles expand the access to our users and allowing them to access to the content anytime, anywhere. We never add titles for the number. We add titles based on real-time usage data directly from the libraries. And there's nothing more satisfying than seeing improved usage by patrons, no matter it's year over year or period over period, or slice the usage by institution type, region, and school specialty. We stay close to the usage data, which guide our content development action steps. And here on the slide show you the continuous effort, the product team to make the collection expanding every year with promising number of new content. And additionally, we surface the content to enhance usage. Our improving discoverability tool help libraries to select, curate, and display the ebooks with seamless integration to the library website, thus helping driving patrons' engagement with the library resources. Next slide, please, Tash. Thank you. So why an Academic Complete as a strong base? Foundational must be the most frequent word I heard in almost every conversation with librarians who have had experience using Academic Complete. So here on the slide is the visual representation of how we see a strong, comprehensive ebook subscription sit in an average academic library acquisition portfolio. You might be already familiar with the different acquisition model presented in the pyramid. And as I mentioned a second ago, having e-everything with unlimited access option for every single book in the library is completely impossible for libraries these days with all the financial restrictions and budget cutting. So we need a strategy here, a cost-efficient yet evidence-based strategy to spend wiser. Ebook subscription, by giving you the coverage of nearly every major, minor, or even curriculum courses, is so crucial to fill the gaps without fully commit to adopt content with full listing price. And in a second, our data expert will also show you how you could leverage the data we collected from the title usage to inform your next step purchasing decision. So as granular as title level, you will be able to justify the e-resource development plan with real data from user engagement. Next slide, please, Tash. So how we develop AC or academic complete, this is the most exciting part and probably what you're interested in hearing the most. How we develop our collection and what are the major content selection rule we use behind the scene. Trending, relevancy, and data-driven would be the three main blocks as guiding principles for our quality selection criteria. First of all, we're up to date. Supporting and sponsoring by the accredited research knowledge, we picked and select subject areas that direct map the what's new happening among the schools, no matter its graduation rate or enrollment rate or industry update. We have it covered and our titles reflect the trend. And relevancy, we continuously monitor our users' academic program update. No fluff in the collection and always being responsive to what we heard and see from the libraries. We ask question, what is demanding and who is using all the time to guide our selection. Last but not the least, data-driven. Thanks for the big data, we see trends and changes every second and we use the actionable analytics to ask the why and how. We then transform the data to our publisher, subject, title selection action steps. And on the slide listed a couple of 2020 to 2021 trending topics we have highlighted within Academic Complete. This comprehensive coverage of content will save you and your library the time and effort that you would never imagine. Next slide, please, Tash. And some of the pragmatic considerations. This slide will be boiling down one level deeper. What are some of the more pragmatic considerations in selections? With the understanding of our customer always want newest, most up-to-date content as possible, our content development team does monthly review with available publishers and sub-eligible titles to make sure at least half of the 200,000 titles were published in the past 10 years. And at the publisher level, going back to the quality versus quantity conversation, we do review and vet publishers before including them. Part of the product team's responsibility is to schedule feedback conversation with libraries in the network on a regular basis. We take your effort seriously. And for example, one publisher was removed from the subscription due to customer feedback regarding factuality in incorrect content. We also make sure that all titles selected are professionally edited and no self-publishing content. And dual rights is the last but not least consideration. It's set by the publisher for restrictions in regions, but since our customers are global, we make every effort to ensure the greatest amount of titles available to all. And I will be wrapping up my section with impressive non-English strategy the team has been working so hard the past 3 years. Tash, would you mind switch to the next slide? Thank you. With a growing 12,000 non-English titles across more than 40 languages, our on-site librarians have been continuously developing diverse content that will support the most relevant research effort. Here on the slide show you the breaking down of non-English content. Academic Complete offer you and your library to build up a truly diverse collection with the value of inclusivity in all voices. The rule the product team use here is what I would call the balanced multi-language approach we're sticking to, so that to ensure a well-balanced and diverse collection. I hope what I share over the past couple of minutes is helpful to you. No matter it's a first intro or a refresh of Academic Complete, Please feel free to drop any questions or reach out after the webinar. I will then pass the section to our team's data expert, Vasudha, to share some interesting analytics around the ebook subscription trend. Thank you.
Thank you, Wei. Hi, everyone. As mentioned earlier, I'm Vasudha Chandramouli, Senior Product Marketing Analyst in the books team here at ProQuest. So as you all know, 2020 was an interesting year. Looking at our data here on how ebook usage trended globally, in the beginning of the year in 2019, ebook central saw usage slowly increasing, which was very similar to the pre-pandemic era in 2020 as well. But once we hit March, COVID-19 disrupted researchers and tasked many librarians and patrons to work and learn remotely. Soon, students became more comfortable using ebooks, and as a result of the transition to online, usage exploded on eBook Central. By the time the new academic year started back in September, this transition became a norm, resulting in heightened usage again, and that has continued this year as well. So as you see, the trend is similar in both perpetual licenses as well as subscriptions, with year-over-year usage being much higher globally in 2021 so far than in prior years, which is very interesting to know. For context here, we define usage as pages copied, printed, and viewed, plus chapter as well as full title downloads. A page viewed is captured as used when the patron spends more than 5 minutes in the slide, in the title, sorry. So now let us look at global changes in usage per library. Next slide. Thank you. Usage per library, as you can see, trended up worldwide. That being said, the UKI saw the strongest usage growth of 39% year over year. This can be largely attributed to the integration with reading lists. EMEA has seen a 15% increase in usage per library, thanks to existing print customers who also pivoted to ebooks when required. Other regions, as you can see, such as North America and ANZ, also saw a year over year increase in usage, thanks to timely adoption of ebooks and strict lockdowns as well. So what does this usage data reveal about user engagement? Can we have the next slide, please, Tash? Thank you. Since the shift to online-only learning, we've seen a significant increase in ebook usage. With the world adjusting to the new normal, an increased need for ebooks has been observed in flexible learning environments. And clearly, better usage for ebooks translates to a better return on investment. So this was, in a nutshell, the usage patterns we saw globally for all of eBook Central. Now let's delve deeper into the specific world of subscriptions usage for our region of focus, which is the UKI here. We looked at subscriptions data specifically in the UKI to see if the trends lined up with what we found globally. Interestingly, at the beginning of the year in both 2019 and 2020, eBook Central subscriptions saw usage remain fairly steady, which is a result of patrons returning to universities and starting off their spring semesters in the UKI, consistent with global trends. With the pandemic hitting in March 2020, there was an initial dip in usage, as you can see here, with universities adjusting to the shift in online learning, as well as Easter break. Post-March, the trend was very similar to what we saw globally. An explosion in usage as students and researchers started getting used to the new balance in learning. Now, as June approached, as you can see, while librarians were still hard at work in the summer months, students were away taking a much needed break. This was followed by a bigger explosion in usage again in the autumn with the ease in online learning and lockdown restrictions. The high usage trend has thus far continued this year. Notice the bold red line for 2021 on top. In fact, you'll see the huge year-over-year spike in usage from 2020 to 2021 in the initial months. That's January through May. Again, reading list integrations have played a pivotal role in this trend. Librarians and faculty have been working closely together towards their goals and teaching and learning. In addition, we must mention that last year, many UKI universities became new subscribers to ProQuest and Academic Complete and needed a large set of content. Hence, the rise in volume is no surprise here. Let's now move on to user engagement. Next slide, please. Thanks. Following the aggregate trends for subscriptions, let's now come down to the level of user engagement on this next slide. We saw rapid growth year over year with regard to how patrons and patrons used our ebook subscriptions. As you can see here, patrons are interacting within the titles more and in different ways. So this is not necessarily worldwide behavior. While there has been overall growth, as we just saw, the level has varied in different countries. Now in the UKI, pages copied grew at the highest rate. With reading lists, there has been an increase in the adoption of content online, including pages viewed. And by copying pages, patrons are able to grab the text they specifically need for the reference later. You can see here that pages printed also saw a spike year over year, which shows that students here are printing out more content to refer to later. Pages printed also includes the ability to save in PDF and captures patrons consuming content offline or outside of the platform as well. This is higher in the UKI than North America, for example, due to the adoption of reading lists in curricula again. This further confirms that subscriptions are supporting reading lists and saving money. Interestingly, around this time last year, pages printed saw a negative growth in year-over-year usage. So it can be inferred that with the ease in online learning over the past year, patrons became more efficient at saving and printing content specific to their needs. And you can see here again, chapter downloads also saw a healthy year-over-year growth. Some of it explained by DRM-free content, which is over 95% of our titles. This also shows that students fatigued from all of the downloading are now taking specifically what they need before exiting the platform. Now that we've got a view of usage for our ebook subscriptions as a whole, let us dive deeper into our focus for today, academic complete. So next on your screen here, you'll see the largest degrees in academic complete highlighted. The focus of librarians is on key subject areas, mapping to graduation rates, and focusing on key fundamentals of curricula building. As you can see, academic complete is a great teaching and learning tool. The content availability shown here is worldwide, while the year-over-year usage stats are specific to the UKI. The reading lists in the UKI hit almost all subject areas. You'll find that while health, engineering, and biological sciences are amongst the most sought-after degrees, all eight of the degrees shown here have seen significant growth in usage year over year at varying levels in the UKI. Academic Complete is very rich in STEM content. It's the leading ebook subscription with STEM, and year over year usage in this area is evidently increasing, as you can see with the numbers here. And interestingly, the most sought after subjects in North America in a year over year comparison were the arts and communication at 14%. Now, the relatively modest percentage increase there being due to a full year's worth of data and more volume there. But with that said, with that academic complete, you can get even more granular with usage at your specific university. So please feel free to reach out to our specialists who can work with you on your specific needs. So having spoken about ebook central trends in general globally, and then coming down to subscriptions in the UKI, and then touching upon academic complete, I'll now hand it over to RJ to take you through some more very interesting trends within academic complete.
Thanks, Vasudha. Hi, everyone. I'm RJ. I'm one of the product marketing managers with the books team at ProQuest, and I'm here to share with you some teaching and learning current trends that we're seeing in academic complete UKI, and we'll share some updates around the content editions. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's start with taking a look at what UKI researchers are using. We've identified the top subject used by researchers in UKI and see that there has been little to no change in the top subjects that patrons are using in 2021. So medicine, history, sociology, economics, and literature still remain the top five subjects overall. And this is what we saw in 2020 as well. I find this interesting compared to North America across the pond. There are popular subjects are history, medicine, religion, philosophy, and education. Interestingly enough, though, globally, we are still seeing no shifts around the teaching and learning trends around the subjects. They're still remaining the same since 2020. Now, let's take a look at the top 12 publishers that are being used in Academic Complete UKI version. As Wei shared, Academic Complete has rich scholarly publishers that fill the content pipeline. So, while Taylor and Francis, Wiley, Elsevier, Cambridge and Oxford University Press, McGraw-Hill, Brill, Walter de Gruyter, Sage and Bloomsbury Publishing still remain the top 12 publishers, I would like to share some insight into what we're seeing in comparative to North America across the pond. Across the pond, we're actually seeing a higher amount of university presses used. So comparatively to UKI, North America is using a lot of the university presses, with 85% of the top publishers used being university presses. However, we definitely are seeing two of the top university press publishers on here as well, with Cambridge University Press and Oxford University Press. Next slide, please. Now let's take a look at the top titles that researchers have been interested in over the past few months in 2021. I'm excited to share that the top used titles touch a variety of disciplines, and this is not by surprise, since the subscription has been designed to be very multidisciplinary. But it's interesting to see that a number of research guidance books still are holding the top spots. So it looks that our researchers are interested in researching methods, nursing, psychology, chemical engineering, leadership, health, and anatomy, and physiology. Now, it's very well known that, you know, the UKI is rich with reading lists, and we understand that these are probably a direct reflection of that. However, I'm delighted to see that in 2021, we're seeing some DEI-related titles taking those top spots, with Black Marxism and neoliberalism among the top titles as well. We're seeing the DEIs becoming more and more incorporated in curriculas, with a focus around several DEI topics, such as Black studies, women's studies, LGBTQ studies, several religion and indigenous people studies as well. While we have over 20,000 DEI related titles in Academic Complete that touch all these important topics, I'm just happy to see that they're starting to bubble up as the top used titles. This also means that they are being added to curriculas, and faculty is interacting with these titles more. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the 10 key subject areas. So with PDE, with the PDE transition last year with the current lockdowns, it was a no-brainer, right? That year over year usage would be up tremendously. But let's take a look at what subjects have seen and enjoyed the most usage last year in the UKI. So health and medicine is up by 71% year over year usage. History is up by 58%. Social sciences is up by 57%. Science and technology is up by 64%, and law is up by 67%. I'm highlighting these because these are the top subjects that have seen the most usage comparative to the rest of the subjects. On your screen, you will find that I have outlined the content additions as of 2021. As we focus on award-winning content and authoritative content, we also focus on content additions that support the trends and emerging degrees globally. And it's insightful to see that the additions are enjoying increased usage as well, proving that we are adding content in the right areas and in trending subject buckets that libraries and users care a lot about. Plus, in the three months in 2021 alone, we added over 400 award-winning titles to the subscription across the subjects. So with Academic Complete being always focused on authoritative and award-winning content, I'd like to leave you with this. Year-over-year usage is high, but you might see something very differently in your university. Make sure you reach out to a book specialist to find what's trending in your university and what are the top subjects that are seeing usage. With that, I would like to hand it over to Anne, who's going to share some insights from her university, from University of Portsmouth, and how they've made their money go further with Academic Complete. Take it away, Anne.
Thanks, Ajay. So if you can move on to the next slide then, please, Tash. So I'm Anne, the Faculty Librarian for Humanities and Social Sciences, and I'd just like to give you a little bit of background about Portsmouth. So we're on the south coast of England, opposite the Isle of Wight, and we are a post-1992 university. We're just south of the city centre, so right in the heart of Portsmouth. And we developed out of the Colleges of Technology, Education and Arts, which had been founded in Portsmouth from the early 1900s. Now, Portsmouth is the home of the Royal Navy, and so as the Navy contracted, the university took over some of their buildings, but we also built some new ones, and you can see the library on the slide there. That's one of our newer buildings. And the ship there is HMS Victory, which was Admiral Lord Nelson's flagship at the Battle of Trafalgar. So the naval dockyard is just 10-15 minutes walk from the university. So we have around 20,000 full-time equivalent students, but a large number of part-timers and a growing number of distance learners. We've had distance learning courses for around 14-15 years, and we currently have 2,200 distance learners, which I think affects some of the statistics that you'll see during our presentation. Now, those students are spread across 5 faculties, and you can see from the list there that we do have a very wide spread of subject coverage. And I'll now hand over to my colleague, Hannah Britcher, who will give you some more facts about Portsmouth's use of eBook Central.
Thank you, Anne. So I'm Hannah, I'm the Leader for Procurement Metadata at University of Portsmouth Library. So a little bit about our systems that we use to manage the eBooks here. So our LMS, we use ESS, so formerly Capita. We use the Soprano, Alto, Prism areas of that. We use the EBSCO Discovery Service, and our reading list software is Talis Aspire, and the university's VLE is Moodle. So that's how we kind of manage our eBooks here. We began a trial of eBooks at the library back in 2004. That included a package of 18,000 or so titles from eBooks Academic Complete, which was the previous name of the eBook Central before ProQuest were involved. And it quickly became clear that our students really enjoyed using the eBooks. We became heavy users of eBooks and the Academic Complete very early on. And as a result of that, we were involved in discussions around the content for the new UKI version of Academic Complete when ProQuest launched that back in 2014. So we had meetings of ProQuest around kind of the subject areas to include, the titles to include, and we moved over to the UKI version in 2017. Have the next slide, please. So probably familiar to many of you that work on the procurement side, our resource budget at the library has been pretty much flat for the last few years. And our subscriptions are still subject to inflation. So in real terms, we actually kind of have a loss of less budget to spend year on year. And this is where some of the subscriptions, the big subscription package really come into their own, I think. So in 1920, 85.6% of our book expenditure was new books. This is a mix of perpetual access and subscription. This was up from 72% on ebooks the previous year. So we're buying more and more ebooks, and individual titles can be very expensive. So the actual number of titles we're buying year on year is less, although we're spending more and more money on them. The big subscriptions like Academic Complete mean that we can afford to have more books available for our students, which is really good. We're in a multi-year deal and has an annual opt-out, which is really important for us. Our finance department requires an annual opt-out for all our multi-year deals, so that's really important. It helps us to really manage the costs and to say provide that ebook content for our students. Next slide, please. So at Portsmouth, we're part of the Southern Universities Collection Consortium. And on their framework, we've chosen ProQuest as our main supplier for a number of areas. So ProQuest is our chosen supplier for our prints and our ebooks, and that includes our perpetual access ebooks, where we buy a mix of kind of single-user licenses, multi-user licenses, individual one-user licenses, the demand-driven acquisition, and academic complete. So ProQuest is our main supplier for all of that. By using a range of procurement models, it means, as I say, we can get more content for our students for the best value. So academic complete is really our base, with our perpetual access and our student, their DDA complementing that, really. Next slide, please. So overall, with the eBook Central here at Portsmouth, we have, as I say, the big academic complete UKI subscription package of over 194,000 titles. And then we complement that with our perpetual access. On our catalogue, at the start of this month, we had over 27,000 perpetual access titles, which we bought over the years. As I say, a mix of single user, three user, and multi user licenses, depending on availability. And we have over 20,000 titles in our DDA package. So we refresh our DDA every summer, and we're triggering about 1,000 titles, students are triggering about 1,000 titles each year. Which is really good. It's actually student-led content there. As has previously been touched upon by ProQuest, there are the title changes, which those of you that subscribe to Academic Complete will be aware of. And actually, kind of any package that you subscribe to, I think from any aggregators, we tend to see this as publishers kind of move things in and out of packages and kind of change their mind about licenses. So, it's not ideal with any package, but it's kind of, I think, part of the thing with any aggregator package. And what we do is we actually have a proactive approach to this here at Portsmouth. So our ProQuest account manager will always provide us with a list of titles to be removed wherever possible ahead of the removal. And we really make sure we check that those titles are either on reading lists or if we have higher usage, and we'll purchase those wherever available and with perpetual access. So it really allows us to be proactive before the books are removed from the package. And of course, we do have the additions to the subscription each year. So our total ebook content is still growing. So the more books available for our students and staff. Next slide, please. And I shall go to Anne.
Okay, so having a look at the subject areas where we're getting most usage from Academic Complete at Portsmouth, business and economics, no surprise it's at the top there because we've got a very large number of students in the business school, but also we have many subject areas that do have modules covering management and also marketing contributing to that use there. But I'm particularly pleased as the librarian for humanities and social sciences to see that five of those top slots are covered by subjects that I look after. So just a word about history. That is now one of our smaller subject areas at Portsmouth. The numbers are decreasing year on year, unfortunately. But the lecturers are very committed to making sure that all the key reading is an ebook or an e-journal article, and they really do channel the students into using the ebooks for all of the weekly reading and the essays, etc., that they're writing. So I think that really does pay tribute to the work that those history lecturers are doing, embedding ebooks so well that history is one of the top four title areas here. We also do have an MA Naval History, which are all distance learners. A lot of them are retired ex-naval officers who are really interested in their subject, and I think that that contributes to the amount of use that history gets too. Languages, we've got MA distance learning courses in translation, applied linguistics, and teaching English as a second language. So I think that does drive the use there, because again, languages is one of the smaller subject areas, but to see history and languages there is very pleasing. And as you've seen from the national usage figures, medicine is really up there because we've got courses covering paramedic science, pharmacy, radiography, optometry, nursing, dentistry, and biomedical science. And we're bidding for a medical school at the moment, so we're glad to see all of the medical coverage that is available in Academic Complete. Okay, next slide, please. So I'm sure it will come as no surprise to librarians in the UK and Ireland that Taylor and Francis and Wiley are at the top of the list there, and you can see that they are quite a way out in front. You may be wondering why Sage is such a way down, and I think for Portsmouth, Sage might have been higher in previous years, but in the current academic year, we actually subscribed to the Sage Catalyst e-textbook package, and I think that's probably taken away some of the usage from Academic Complete there. John Benjamin's is quite a small publisher relative to the others. And I think this again underlines the use that our MA translation students and MA applied linguistics students are making of ebooks, because John Benjamin's is a publisher which caters very much to the translation and linguistics subject area. Okay, next slide, please. So just to share with you some of our top titles from 2021. You can see that criminology features very heavily here because criminology is one of our growth areas. It's currently got one of the largest numbers of undergraduate students, but we've also got lots of postgraduates in criminology and lots of distance learners too. And criminology has topped the usage charts as far as eBook Central goes, certainly for the last 10-15 years at Portsmouth, so it's no surprise to us to see it dominating here. But you can also see some titles from psychology, and again, psychology is an area with a large number of undergraduate students. And then at the bottom of the list of these top 12 titles, we've got the Sponsor Architects and Builders Prize book, and that's being used heavily by our architects and civil engineers. Okay, next slide, please. So just to look in contrast now at just the top used titles within Academic Complete, the previous list was showing some titles which we've bought outright as well. But you can see that again in Academic Complete usage at Portsmouth, criminology forensics does feature quite heavily, but this time we've got some business, computing, and also sociology coming in. So that gives you an indication of some of the titles you can access in Academic Complete as well across a range of subject areas. Next slide, please. So right from the beginning of ebooks at Portsmouth back in 2004, we took the decision to put our ebooks onto the catalogue to make them easily discoverable. So all of our ebook central collection is on the catalogue, and that pulls through into our discovery all-in-one search service as well. And then individual lecturers and librarians we'll add the individual ebook titles onto our Talis Aspire online reading list. Now, within Moodle, we have the Aspire reading list linked at the top of the list so that students can access the whole reading list. But over the last year as well, a new Moodle template came in, and we've been embedding weekly sections of reading into the weekly sections within Moodle, and that has proved very popular and I think led to some of the higher usage of some of the books that we've got access to. And you can see that the ebooks are very popular with the students, and I've got a quote from a second year criminology student here. They really do like ebook central, where you can get unlimited user access, which is very important in criminology, where they have got hundreds of students each needing the book at the same time. Okay, next slide, please. So again, right from the beginning, we took the decision that we needed to promote ebook central to the lecturers before tackling the students, really. So as soon as we meet new lecturers, we present ebook central to them to make sure that they know how to use all the features, because we think that if lecturers are excited by the features there, then they're much more likely to want to use those books with the students as well. Now, in my areas of humanities and social sciences, and also our science subjects, we're very fortunate that we get hands-on workshops with the students as part of their seminar replacements. And so we have the time to show the students eBook Central as part of library introductions. And we can see how the students really love tools like the highlighter and the bookshelf. And it always causes a real talking point around the room. Once the students discover the highlighter pens, you can see them nudging each other, showing each other what they've highlighted. And they really do go to town trying out the different colours of highlighters. And then, of course, the next question is how you unhighlight when they realise they've done too much. But they do get so enthusiastic with those features. Librarians in other subject areas aren't quite so fortunate to have the hands-on workshops, but they certainly introduce eBook Central as part of lectures to the students. And you can see a comment from a literature student there pointing out how she likes the highlighter pens and bookmarking. Okay, next slide, please. So March 2020, along came the pandemic lockdown. And at that point, we had to start reviewing all our reading lists to make sure that ebook content was maximised as much as possible. Because certainly this time last year, or sorry, March last year, we had quite a few print books on reading lists. So we did a review to make sure that everything that was on the catalogue as an ebook was then on the reading list, because sometimes lecturers had just put the print book on and not the ebook. So library staff went through and added ebooks where they weren't there. But we also went through checking Oasis to see whether there were any more ebooks that we could buy. And fortunately, Core Text had the free e-textbook offering between March and July last year. So we certainly took advantage of that. But at that point, when the free e-textbook offering stopped, we then had this huge problem of what do we do? We had all of the key titles. Obviously, eBook Central was catering for quite a lot of them, but we still had key titles which we couldn't find via standard eBook routes. And some of them were only sold as either one user or three user titles via eBook Central. And £200 to £400 for a one user or £500 to £600 for a three user was simply not a sustainable price, where we had hundreds of students on a module needing to access those texts. So at that point, whereas in the past we'd only had a handful of e-textbooks, we were forced into subscribing to a range of e-textbooks in the 2020-21 academic year. So we took Sage Catalyst, as I said, which offered us 500 e-textbooks. And we also took Oxford Law Trove and Politics Trove. So they were costing us so much more that at that point we were really glad that we could still fall back on academic complete to provide that real range, broad spread of coverage to pick up where we weren't being able to buy books in particular subjects anymore. Okay, next slide, please. So just to give you a flavour of what was happening with our permanent purchases compared to our demand-driven acquisition here. We'd had demand-driven acquisition for a few years prior to 2018-19, and we think that it kind of reached a peak in 18-19. So you can see that 18-19, roughly the same number of DDA titles were triggered as we bought as permanent purchases. You can see there's a difference in price there because the DDA titles were triggered as single user, whereas titles that we were buying, we would be buying them sometimes with three user or unlimited user licenses. So then the year of COVID, you can see that the DDA titles dropped back quite significantly, whereas the outright purchases increased. So we bought about another 300 outright purchases as we went through the reading list to identify extra purchases which would help our students whilst they were away from Portsmouth in lockdown. And then 2020-21, more or less the same number of DDAs triggered, but half the number of permanent purchases because we did buy so many of them the previous academic year. Okay, next slide, please. So comparing our use now of academic complete compared to permanent purchases over the last three academic years, you can see that each year the number of titles used which are permanent purchases is roughly half the number of academic complete titles which has been used. But if you look at total usage, the total usage of the titles that we've bought outright is roughly double that of academic complete titles. And it's no surprise there to see the usage so high for the titles we bought outright, because as I've indicated, we do buy them to meet reading list needs, but we will also buy them at the request of individual dissertation students, whether they're undergraduates or postgraduates. And you would expect that if they request something, that they then go on to make high use of it. And in some years, we've also bought the outright purchases in response to high numbers of reservations. But you can see that despite the use being slightly less for the academic complete titles, there is a much wider range of titles which has been used. So we certainly could not do without that very broad spread of coverage that we get in academic complete. And personally, I feel very much that academic complete over the last year has taken up that role of perhaps the wider coverage. In previous years, we might have bought a little bit wider than reading lists where we spotted titles that we thought might have been useful. But certainly during the current academic year, where the budgets have been smaller and we've had to spend more on e-textbooks, we've not been able to do that. So I think academic complete has very much substituted for that wider buying that we might have done in the past. So I'm really glad that we are still subscribers to that academic complete collection. Okay, next slide then. So that's it for the presentation from Portsmouth. You've got our email addresses on the screen if you've got anything you want to follow up on afterwards. But I believe that we've now got a little bit of time to hand back to Tash and the eBook Central team.
Thank you, Anne, and thank you, Hannah, as well, for your insights into your experience with Academic Complete. And it's so great to hear that after all these years and after being a partner with us on creating the UKI version, that you're still really pleased and you're still seeing such healthy, fantastic usage. So thank you very much. And also thank you to our three ProQuest Books experts and gurus for their presentation and their slides. As Anne said, we have 5 minutes for the Q&A session, and I just want to check in with Nick to see if there's any questions in the chat, and if not, I know a couple have come through to me that I'd like to share. But Nick, is there anything in the chat before I move into my questions?
Nothing at the moment. So yeah, Tash, if you want to start with the questions we've already had, that'd be great.
Perfect. So the first question, and I think this one's probably for Wei-Yi, if you're good to take it, are what additions are coming next to Academic Complete in 2021?
Sure, thank you, Tash. Thank you for the question. We will be continuously adding quality titles with fall in our 10 key subjects, both from the real-time usage data collected from the UKI region and also the latest higher education program enrollment and graduation trend. A couple of examples would be history, health and medicine, which we saw a surge of usage in the past 6 months, science and technology or STEM titles, which we have see improvement in usage. And additionally, with the continuous hybrid learning mode, we're hoping to add more leisure reading, distance learning, self-help, mental health, and counseling content to ensure our students and faculties have the tool to enhance teaching and learning experience within and beyond classroom in this new normal phase. And last but not least, DEI or diverse equity and inclusion related content would be a very important topic. We focus on consideration, including by authors of diverse background, titles published in different languages. Yes.
That's brilliant. Thank you so much, Wei-Yi. Mm-hmm. So question number two, and I think I'll pose this one to RJ, if you're good to take it, is could you share some insight into the title removal process, please?
Thanks, Tash. That's actually a really great question. You know, that's something that our librarians have asked us many times in the past. With titles removed, you know, uncertainty or, you know, with titles removed in general from subscriptions. I will share that we have so many subscribers for Academic Complete globally. Something that they have just come very used to is our titles removal process. Something that ProQuest or the books team is really big about is making sure that we are transparent for when these titles are being removed. The titles get removed from in June and in December yearly. And one of the questions we get is why are these titles being removed? Publishers actually drive these changes, and they decide what titles get removed from the subscription. Of course, we work with publishers to keep as many titles within the subscription so that we're not disrupting your collection strategies and if any of these titles are incorporated into teaching and learning. Something to keep in mind whenever a title removal process is done in June or December. We actually make it a point to add 1-to-1 ratio. So what does that mean? When one title is removed from subscription or from Academic Complete, we make sure that we add it with one. So we always are balancing what is removed and what is added. We also try to make sure that we're adding the relevant title by 1-to-1. So for example, if there was a title removed in social science, we will make it a point to add one title in back into social science to make sure that we're balancing our collection. Another thing to keep in mind is the growth. Our goal is to grow Academic Complete by 5% year over year. So we add fresh content in, as Wei-Yi mentioned, on a quarterly basis through the academic year. So we add content in 4 times a year, and our goal is to hit a 5% growth rate year over year. I'm happy to share that last year we grew by 6% with Academic Complete, and the year prior to that we grew at 16%. These are the percentages I have right off the top of my head. However, something to keep in mind is that we've never missed our growth goal for academic complete. We're continually adding content in to make sure that you have fresh, relevant content to have in front of your users and patrons. Now, do off cycles happen? Absolutely. You know, very, 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 very small amount of off cycle removals happen during the year. These are also publisher driven, but they are very restricted to legal issues or if the file is corrupted and can be viewed on eBook Central. Again, like I mentioned, it's a very, very small amount that come out. And it usually is, you know, if that title is not being able to be used in that geographical region, or if there's a legal issue and the publisher needs it removed immediately. So that sort of goes through our titles removal in academic complete. I hope I've kind of answered it well. If anyone has any more questions, feel free to ask.
No, that's fantastic, RJ, and thank you so much for answering that question. I do believe we are at time. I know it went so quickly. So again, I just wanted to express my gratitude to all of the speakers today, especially Hannah and Anne. And we appreciate that this time of the year is incredibly busy for libraries. So the fact that you would dedicate some of your time to talk about your experiences as academic complete really means a lot. So thank you both for that. And also thank you so much for my ProQuest colleagues from the Books Unit for sharing your expertise on this election. And it's really great to see that it's still growing and it still is ever popular, not just in the UK, but all around the world. On the screen now, you can see just a quick note about a white paper that we produced at ProQuest, ebook acquisition in the UK before and after the pandemic struck. So if you did want to request a copy, there are details and you can contact Nick and the marketing team to do that. Like I said, this session has been recorded and we will share that with the invitees in short time, and also so that you can share it with your colleagues as well who weren't able to take part today. Thank you again for joining us, and we hope that you'll be with us for the next couple of days. The next 2 days on the Books Week are going to take a really sharp and detailed focus on DEI. So tomorrow we'll have a panel of our publisher partners. And then on Thursday, we'll talk about what we're doing at ProQuest to make content as diverse and accessible as possible. So all that leaves me to do is to wish you all a fantastic day, afternoon or evening, wherever you are, and take care and stay safe. Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you, Tash. Thanks, Nick.